Hello, this is Buona from Buona.tv, and I want to talk about Elite Dangerous and the Fleet Carriers Patch 3, sort of an addendum or an update video. Lots have happened since my last video, even though it's barely been a day. I just want to give you guys a quick update as to the happenings of what's going on with the patch. I gotta say, it's not good. The things we've been finding regarding low temperature diamond mining and mining in general and trading in general has been a little bit concerning. The first thing that I want to point out is that the major problems we're seeing today have all stemmed around the mining changes and the ring changes and the hotspot changes that happen as a result of patch 3. If you don't know what's going on, patch 3 was supposed to buff single hotspots and nerf triple hotspots. Instead, what players are seeing and have been confirming, and I've confirmed it myself, mining has dried up. The rings don't provide hardly any yield at all. And it's a massive decrease compared to what it was before. To say that it was buffed is a mistake. So that's a big problem. And this is how it's a big problem. Number one, fleet carriers out in the black that rely on mining to restore their tritium are now stranded. I'm not kidding. Once they run out of fuel, they have no way of replenishing their fuel. You know, what was supposed to be a rebalancing act for low temperature diamonds and demand and stuff has turned into a huge problem. These commanders are now stranded. So the Broken Limpet and others, including myself, I'm buying up all the tritium I can find before the demand dries up. We'll talk about that in a second. We're going to try to organize some efforts to rescue or provide tritium to these commanders so they don't have to decommission their fleet carriers because they're stranded. And these are guys in the DSSA. If you don't know what the Deep Space Support Array is, it's a very noble player-driven effort to provide rest stops or repair refuel stations for explorers out in the black. So these guys are in a pickle right now because they have no means of restocking tritium with the current mining changes. Not only that, I talked about this in my previous video, but demand is now much more volatile. I mentioned that it was dynamic before, but it is supremely, it is severely volatile. Maddie over it at the Broken Limpet did a test for me, and he found a station. I put the screenshots on the screen. He found a station that offered 234,000 tons of trit for demand, tritium. And it took an hour to deplete that. 1 hour and 234,000 tons. That's an insanely high amount of demand was gone. And like I said in my previous video, the worst case scenarios for these demand changes is that before you can even get to a station that has what you need, it's going to be gone. That is a very drastic thing. Another concerning thing that we found is that this happens for all commodities, not just tritium, not just low temperature diamonds, which means that trading in general has been affected by this. The game's in a pretty weird state right now. A lot of us are trying to regroup and figure out what's what and how to approach it. The game is not dead by any means, but everything's different. When it comes to trading is the main thing that I'm discussing right now, because that includes mining as well. When it comes to trading, things are kind of at an impasse. Fleet carriers, as a result of all of this, have diminished in value tremendously. Given that tritium right now is going to be a rare commodity, and it's getting rarer by the second. If you look at the demand on the Nara, on what people are reporting, demand dries up so fast, and it just sits at one for a lot of these stations that had thousands, hundreds of thousands of tritium. Now, I'm not just talking about tritium at a low price. I'm talking about tritium in general. It's drying up really, really fast. How fast it replenishes itself, we're at the mercy of the BGS. For those that state that this is expected, this is how we should play a game with supply and demand, this is how economy works, I agree with you. This is how economy works, with supply and demand. However, Elite Dangerous's economy is not your typical economy. It is simulated. So supply is out of our control. We have very limited control on supply. We can manipulate the BGS to provide favorable conditions for supply, but that is it. So if something runs out, we simply have to sit and wait for it to pop up somewhere else. We don't have any control over that, which makes it a little bit constraining. So while having a proper economy is a goal of a lot of Elite Dangerous players, having a proper supply and demand, you need to do it completely. You need to have a full supply provided by players and demand fulfilled by players. And right now it's kind of a one-way street from a player perspective. So not a good day, not a good patch. Overall, I think it's probably one of the worst patches in a while. I hope Frontier provides a hot fix, mainly for, and this is the glaring issue, mainly for the mining hotspots. The hotspots are dry. It's not that there's the prices have been nerfed. It's not that we're not getting insane amounts of yield anymore. They are essentially dry. You can mine for hours and find 2 to 3 prospected rocks of low temperature diamonds, of void opals, whatever you're looking for, of anything, painite. This is not limited to the really, really, this is everything across the board when it comes to hotspots. And it's a huge problem. A hot fix is definitely going to be required for that. If they don't hot fix this, mining in itself, not just lucrative mining, but mining in itself will be severely crippled. So I'm hoping Frontier is going to do something about this very soon. I imagine a lot of people are going to be leaving anyway because of certain other nerfs, like the ship launch fighter thing. I know some people are going to leave because of that, and you know, that's expected. Certain people are going to leave because of the tritium problems, and they probably have a fleet carrier that they want to jump around the galaxy, they want to go explore with, and with no means of replenishing tritium, that's what we're faced with. There's no means of replenishing tritium. Why own a fleet carrier? There's gonna be several decommissioned fleet carriers if this doesn't get changed. So huge problem. The demand issue, I think, is a more of a knowledge thing. I think we can adapt if rates are adjusted. I think if the deplenishing, if the deplenishing rates are adjusted as our knowledge grows, I think we can work with the demand changes, even though personally I don't particularly like them. I think that we can work around that, and I think we can make something work, but that's a long shot. When it comes to the hotspots though, we're at the mercy of Frontier. They're dead. They're completely dry. The only way that's going to get fixed is if they fix it. So we're at their mercy. Lots of things to ponder. If you're a new player to Elite Dangerous, you're probably going, whoa, what happened? Even if you're a veteran, like I've seen a couple veterans say, this is probably the biggest change that the patch has brought and that they can remember. They say of all time. And I'm thinking back on the patches and what things got adjusted and some things that didn't work. And this one's a doozy. The fact that it affects all mining and the fact that it affects all trading and one patch is a sup. It's not even a major update. It's just a patch. Is kind of big. Making credits at this point is a question mark. So if your purpose is to buy a fleet carrier, making credits is a question mark. And I would definitely hold off. Look into other parts of the game. If you're still going to play Elite Dangerous, look into unlocking engineers. Look into trying different things, look into probably playing the BGS, get into power play, you know, unlock some modules, look into other parts of the game. But if you're just specifically looking at making credits right now, it is a huge question mark, because the major ways of making credits are not gone. Trading and mining are not gone. And the other methods of making credits, such as exploration, combat, and missions, are still there from what I can see. I haven't tried them myself because they don't rely on trading commodities and buying and selling. So those are still there. But as you know, they haven't always been the most lucrative. I think a lot of players are going to turn to passengers at Robigo and Sothis again to see if that actually still is profitable, because last time I checked, the last time I did it was like patch 2 of fleet carriers. Sothis and Robigo runs were actually still profitable. So while credits haven't completely dried up, there's a giant question mark there. And this is a good time. If you've made a lot of credits, if you've made billions, if you've made a lot on diamonds, this is a good time to explore other parts of the game. I tell new players this all the time on my stream. Don't make credits your main reason for playing the game. Find something you like to do and do a ton of it. So explore the game. Try to figure out what you like to do. And don't let credits drive you. Also, engineers is a massive grind. So if you want to grind some more, there's your boy. There's your grind spot. If you just like grinding, if the credit grind was like attractive, the engineers are waiting. Ooh-wee, yes they are. This is Buona from Buona.tv, and an update on Fleet Carriers Patch 3. Hopefully Frontier issues a hot fix, because right now it is kind of bad. I don't know how else to say it. It's kind of bad. And I'm looking forward to their response, if there's a hot fix or if there's going to be any changes. Again, we can work around the demand, you know, even though it's kind of drastic. I'm hoping that the trickle rates are adjusted. But the mining changes, the hotspot changes, they've got to get fixed, because they're dead in the water right now. Take care, guys. Leave a comment, like, subscribe. Let me know what you think about what's going on. And I'll see you next time. Have a good day. Bye-bye.